back to my channel. Thank you so much for watching. So today I am on my way to my first ever panel that I'm going to do with Black Girls Break Bread. They are a nonprofit organization that kind of just inspires and encourages African-American women and children just to be a trailblazer in your field of work and try and just get some inspiration. So I'm so happy to be a part of that. And I am currently on my way, but you guys don't even know what happened to me today. So I've been having this allergic reaction, and that's kind of why I've been posting like pre-recorded videos, because I haven't made any like live ones because of this allergic reaction. Thank God it's going away, but you can still kind of see it just a little bit. So I'm just hoping that I don't have any like major flare-ups during this thing, like pray to God. But as you can see, I have some new hair over here. Shout out to Diva Trist. I'm just on my way and I am excited. I'm just so thrilled. I'm just, listen. And look at this eyeshadow work right here. I don't know who this eyeshadow is. I actually have like the actual purple is from the Morphe Zodiac palette, and I think this is in the color Sagittarius. And then on my actual, the glitter, I don't know what that's from. That was like in the goodie bag from BeautyCon LA. And listen, this is some good stuff right there. So I'm so excited to bring you, I'm so excited to bring you guys along the way for today's event. I'm very, very excited and just so stoked and so grateful that I was even considered. So you guys will see all the fun stuff unfold. Just please keep watching. Now into my panel, I believe. Let's see. I didn't even show you guys what I was wearing. Akira, of course. Thank you. Akira, of course.
Four, maybe like many more. She dreams to merge her interest in communication with beauty and hope to inspire young girls along the way. Let's give a warm welcome to the leader of the next generation, Ms. Dr.
So basically, just to answer your question, for me, my background is, I'm 22, so I'm just a little younger than them, but for me, I grew up in a predominantly white suburb, and I was always the only Black girl on anywhere. And for me, I knew that it was really quick for me to find, I needed to find my identity, because if I didn't, it was going to be appointed to me. So for me, it was really important just to stay close to God so that He could lead me into where He wanted me to be, and He led me to Columbia College, Chicago, and that was very different from Schaumburg, from where I'm from. And with that, it was very diverse, and it was very kind of like a culture shock. And I was surrounded by so many diverse women, and not only just women, but also other groups of people. And I knew at that moment that I had just not been exposed to everything that I was supposed to. So when I was looking for a creative outlet, I started a YouTube channel because who watches YouTube more than they watch TV? Like, am I the only one? Like, I would love to be on YouTube, and I would love to start creating content. But I noticed that in the same way, kind of like in high school, it's very kind of clicky. It's very like there wasn't all the YouTubers that I watched did look like me. They were, again, those same girls that I would see in high school. So I kind of said, how can I be that for other young girls that watch YouTube, you know? So I began a YouTube channel focused on beauty and fashion and faith, and it kind of just took off on its own. And with that, I wanted to answer your question on how to take the mask off. I knew that it was very important to be authentic and also be willing to help others, because I think in media or wherever I've interned, like NBC Chicago PD, also being the only Black person on set. The only other Black people were Empire in the lot. So I think that I was able to see with taking the mask off that there's room for all of us to grow, and it's room for all of us to succeed, and it's really not a competition, because what's really meant for you will always be for you. It doesn't matter if someone has better this or more experience that. Like, there's always room for everyone to grow, so, and everyone to win. So I think taking the mask off, kind of bouncing back off of what you all said, is that it's not a competition. Like, it's okay to help people. It's okay to give advice. It's okay to say, yeah, I went through this way to get there, and no, it wasn't easy. And I think it's also okay to just be authentic. I think we always, as Black women especially, have to act like we have everything together, all our ducks in a row. Like, nope, I got this, nope, it's okay. Yeah. And I think it's okay to get help, because there are people that are always gonna be smarter than you, they're always gonna know more than you know, and that's why we were even created to coexist, is to help each other. So that's how it helps me take off the mask, is giving advice and being receptive to advice, because one of the things that I really struggle with is constructive criticism. That's always been a weakness that I've had. So that's also just really, really helped me, is being receptive too. So that's what I would say about taking your mask off. So mask off, take your mask off.
Hey!
Oh, this
is
delicious.
Thank you.
Okay, perfect.